नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन द मैथमेटिकल रीजनिंग इज कन्वर्स, इनवर्स एंड कंट्रा पॉजिटिव. एंड लेट मी टेल यू, बेसिक थिंग इज दैट दीज थ्री आर वेरी मच कोरिलेटेड विद द कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट. ओके, सो नाउ लेट मी एक्सप्लेन यू बेसिकली वॉट दिस इज. नाउ एक्सप्लेनेशन, फर्स्ट पार्ट. After explaining and briefing, then we are going with individually what is converse, what is inverse, and what is contrapositive. Now, the composite sentence that is used most in mathematics is conditional. That's what I told you, that this is related with the conditional, all the three. Okay, now if P, then Q. Now, we have already gone through the conditional. We are using if P, then Q. Okay. Now, if P, then Q is the given conditional statement then we can form other closed terms, that is relatives. We can say closed terms, or we can say just relatives for the conditional statement. Okay, so then we can form the other closed terms relatives, namely number one converse, number two inverse, and number three contrapositive. If P then Q is the given conditional statement, then we can form other closed terms, relatives, namely converse, inverse, and contrapositive to the conditional statement. Now, before discussing converse, inverse, and contrapositive, let me again give you a briefing for the conditional statement. Okay, now here, now in this briefing, I am going to use some other words, other terms I am going to use it, okay? Just to make explanation very clear, very light. It will be very much easily understandable. Now, a statement with the hypothesis which words we can use is, antecedent, and a conclusion to this we can use it consequent, that is if P then Q, if P then Q. Now in the sentence, now for example, we went for an example. If it is raining, then there will be no match. Okay. So if it is raining, hypothesis, then there will be no match, conclusion. If it is raining, antecedent, then there will be no match, that is the conclusion. Is it clear? So now the hypothesis, now first of all let's discuss for the if part. Now what is if here? Now if is the hypothesis, also called antecedent. Now the hypothesis antecedent, what basically this is, if is the here we can write it, if is the independent variable, is the independent variable. Now it has to happen in order for the conclusion to happen. So this is the very first word, that is P. Okay. So the independent variable, what is that? Is if. Okay. And it has to happen in order for the conclusion to happen. Now what is the second word? That is then. Now for then, the conclusion is called consequent. Now here then is the dependent variable. Okay, then is the dependent variable. Now what this means? It cannot occur unless the hypothesis occurs. On basis of these, all these things, the second is what? Then. Then is what? Dependent variable. And dependent variable cannot happen or cannot occur unless hypothesis does not happen. Now on the base of this small briefing, what we did? We made a truth table for the conditional. What it was? Truth table. If then. Now we have already done it. Suppose we are having P implies Q. So it was, we were having if it happens, both hypothesis and conclusion, it was true. Then hypothesis is there, conclusion we can't get it, it is false. Now hypothesis is right or wrong, but conclusion is there, this was true, and if both are false, then also it was true. So this was based on the all these statements what I have written. And why I have used these words? Because we are going to use these words for converse, inverse and contrapositive.